In this lab, we'll use a calibrated torsional spring to spin a disc. By measuring the torque and the angular acceleration, we can infer the moment of inertia of the disc, and then we'll add other things and look at how that moment of inertia changes. We'll want the mass of our bare disc, the additional disc we'll add, and the bar we'll add. We'll also want the dimensions of these things that we're going to add. And because this is pulling, we need to know the moment arm that it pulls at. And so we will very accurately measure with a set of vernier calipers the inner diameter of the small and medium spools that we'll be using. If you're not sure how to use vernier, look at the other instructional materials on Blackboard and talk to your TA. Once we've measured the mass of these objects and the relevant dimensions, take your disc with the spools and put it spool side down on the axle, gently placing it, and then connect the string to the torsional spring. Wind it up just a little, and then make sure that your alignment is good, that the string as it comes out of the hole is not rubbing, and that the string is close to level, so that all of the torque is going right into here. You want to make sure for your first run that the string winds around the pulley, the spool, and not the axle. You can use a crochet hook to adjust where the spring lies if needed to make sure that it winds around the correct part. Holding it back, winding it on, pulling the crochet hook out. Wind it up until the hook is almost on the inside, but just the string and not the hook is wound around the spool. Your lab quest we use to measure when these pegs block the photogate beam. There are two pegs on the disc and they block it every 180 degree rotation, so a pi in radians. Make sure that you're set to photogate timing, mode none, and end data with the stop collection, because you'll need different amounts of data for different runs. Then, start your lab quest. Release the disc and allow the torsional spring to pull on the string, exerting a torque and spinning this. Stop the disc before your string runs completely out so that there's not a sudden jerk. Then, stop the lab quest. Depending on how you stop it, you may have to discard your last point if it was near the photogate as you stopped it. Export that data to a text file, and then allow each member of the group to do their own data run on the small spool. Then, using a crochet hook, wind around the medium spool, check the alignment of your spring, and do another data run, exporting it, saving it, and again, stopping before that collides. Let each member of the group do that. Then you'll take the two objects and do two more runs per person where you put the object on top, wind the string around the medium-sized spool, and then starting from rest, start your data, let that go, collect the data, export it, and then you're ready to do the other object, allowing each member to do both objects and get data runs from both.